Hi, Donna Sirianni here, Leadership Success Coach and founder of Success Compass Academy. So today, I want to give you a few tips to improve your performance and your productivity and feel better about what you're getting done. And, you know, I'm wondering if this is true for you. If you feel like, you know, there just aren't enough hours in the day, I'm not getting as much done throughout the day, I just don't have the energy to get it all done, I'm not as clear and focused and productive as I'd like to be. Does any of that resonate with you? Because it's actually something that not only do I occasionally feel like that, but also many of the clients that I work with feel that way. So I want to share some tips with you. Now, typically, my Success Compass Academy programs will step you through how to know what your strengths are, your values, passions, your vision, really know what career choices to make that are best for you, navigate good choices so that you get your best results, right? But what I want to share with you are a couple of things that are the foundation. It's sort of productivity 101. And if you don't have these tips today that I'm sharing with you today, then you really need to start here, because no matter what you do, this is going to be what's really going to drive having the energy to tackle what you know needs to get done. So a couple of tips, and none of these are rocket science. You've probably heard them before, but I'm sharing them with you because these have had a huge impact on my own productivity. Number one is sleep. Now, I know you've heard this a lot, but I want to give you a couple of tips on increasing your sleep. You know, everybody knows you need 7 to 9 hours of sleep every night, good solid sleep. Now, when you don't get a good night's sleep, what happens? You wake up in the morning, you're groggy, maybe you grab a cup of caffeine to perk yourself up, you head into the office, but your brain's kind of foggy, you really can't think clearly. So it's crucial, again, productivity 101, you absolutely need to get a good night's sleep. Now, for me, for many, many years, this was a problem. I tossed and turned, maybe it was stress, maybe it was what I ate, but I just wasn't sleeping well. So here's a couple of tips that I've implemented for years that work really, really well. Number one is during the day, you absolutely need to get some fresh air and preferably some exercise. So even going for a walk for 30 minutes, but be outside in nature, fresh air. That is crucial for you then at nighttime to get a good night's sleep. Okay. The next tip is make sure you remove all the electronics from your bedroom. Don't be watching TV in bed. Take that digital clock if you have one next to your bed, your iPhone, whatever it is you use, and get that out of your bedroom, preferably. But maybe your alarm clock could be far enough away you've got to actually get up, right? And here's something that I learned when I lived in Asia, because I got certified in feng shui and I was so desperate to improve my sleep. I did everything. I put special stones and crystals under my pillow. I would try anything to get a good night's sleep. But there's one thing that I'm now adamant about. Two things. One, no ambient light in the room. I don't want light coming in through the curtains or the blinds. I make sure the room is really dark. And if I'm traveling, I put on a sleep mask, because if there's light in the room, maybe it's from something that I have turned on or just light from a street light, that light just very gently wakes me up. Okay. Got to have a dark room. But here's the feng shui piece. Do not have any mirrors in your bedroom that reflect you while you're sleeping. Now you could say, oh, that's crazy. But you know what? I'm adamant about it. I sleep like a baby. But if there's a mirror, this is feng shui, is all about energy. And the mirror in your bedroom, if it reflects you while you sleep, whatever's troubling you and on your mind, it amplifies, magnifies it, you know, tenfold, right? It reflects it and amplifies it. Okay. So that's just like a little tip from Asia to improve your sleep. But that's crucial. Again, if you're really well rested, you get up in the morning, you feel great, you go into the office, you start your work, it's going to give you an edge. Tip number two is about nutrition. Now, again, I'm not a nutritional expert, but I'm going to tell you the impact this has had in my life. For years, working in technology and really stressful jobs, I'd go into the office, get a big, huge latte from Starbucks filled with sugar and dairy and caffeine, and maybe I'd use that caffeine to pump myself up all day. But then that doesn't have, you know, too much caffeine, right? Start can make you jittery. But then what would I eat for breakfast? I might have a cinnamon raisin bagel, some comfort food, something that really tasted so good with lots of butter because, oh, I deserve it. I've got a big, stressful day, and I'm going to have this little treat. All right, wrong thing, no protein or anything. So for lunch, I'm on the run, eating sandwiches, pizza, whatever I can get my hands on. Okay. So tip number two around nutrition or your diet. I have been gradually getting off of caffeine, off of sugar, off of dairy, no bread. You might say, oh my God, what are you eating? I'm eating a best diet I've ever had, which is the closest thing I could tell you about is if you were to read the book Whole 30, that's probably the closest to it. But anyway, a lot more natural whole food, super healthy, and I have never felt better. My mental clarity, focus, discipline, productivity is through the roof when I'm eating well. Good night's sleep, eating well, does wonders for your brain. But here's the other thing. If you're treating yourself in a stressful situation to some sugar, that's making it worse because the sugar actually fogs your brain. Now you don't have clear thinking. The last thing you could do that would be good for you before you go into a meeting would be like have a candy bar, have a cookie or something, you know, something that's going to convert quickly to sugar. Okay. Now, tip number three is around exercise. And again, I'm sure you know exercise is really good for your health, but what I'm talking about today is productivity. So when you have something really important coming up, maybe it's a project you need to work on. If you get up in the morning and on your way to work, before you go to work, whatever, or even during the day, go for even a 30-minute walk outside, through a park, down the street. Just be in nature, but go for a walk. Even that 30 minutes of exercise will help you to gain that. It's based on neuroscience. It will help you gain some mental clarity. Now, within the few hours following exercise, you will have this surge of clarity, focus, mental energy, and creativity. So it will do wonders for your productivity. So those are my tips for today. These are things I've been experimenting with for a long time. I swear by them, and I know if I've got a big project, something really important, and I follow these tips, I'm absolutely at my best, and this is what I want for you. So hopefully this was helpful. And if you'd like more tips, I would invite you to subscribe to my podcast, The Success Talk Show. Just jump over to iTunes for The Success Talk Show, or you can find it on thesuccesstalkshow.com. Or if you like video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, Donna Sirianni. So anyway, have a great day.